गुड मॉर्निंग, लेट अस डिस्कस अबाउट द जनरल इफेक्ट्स ऑफ फॉल्ट एंड व्हाट इज द सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ फॉल्ट। सो व्हाट इज द इफेक्ट ड्यू टू फॉल्टिंग और व्हाट इज द इफेक्ट ऑफ फॉल्ट। वी नो फॉल्ट्स आर वेरियस टाइप्स, दैट इज नॉर्मल फॉल्ट, रिवर्स फॉल्ट, थ्रस्ट फॉल्ट और स्ट्राइक फॉल्ट, स्ट्राइक स्लिप फॉल्ट और डीप फॉल्ट। सो व्हाट इज द इफेक्ट ऑन द बेडिंग प्लेन बाय दिस फॉल्ट। सो ड्यू टू फॉल्टिंग यंगर बेड्स ऑफ डाउन थ्रोन साइड विल कम इन कॉन्टैक्ट विथ ओल्डर बेड्स ऑफ द अप थ्रोन साइड अलॉन्ग द फॉल्ट प्लेन। This is the example of, see, this is in this bedding or rock strata, three beds are present, 1, 2, 3, and one is your older bed and three is your younger bed. Due to faulting, here one means older bed is overlap with the younger bed, that is three. So due to faulting, younger beds of down thrown side, this is your down thrown side, this is your up thrown side. So younger bed of the down thrown side will come in contact with older beds of up thrown side along the fault plane. On erosion, the same effect is revealed by the outcrops along the fault trace. So let us see the what is the effect of faulting on horizontal bed. So in case of horizontal beds, due to faulting and erosion, younger beds of the down throw side will come in contact with the older beds of the up throw side along the fault plane or trace. Same thing, here is the horizontal bed or horizontal beds in a bedding plane or rock strata, and due to faulting, this is your fault, normal fault, the younger bed of down thrown side will meet to the older beds of the up thrown side. Then next come to the effect on inclined bed. The effect on inclined bed produce deep fault. Okay, so the outcrops inclined beds in up throw side appear to have advanced in the direction of the dip. Here is the opposite of horizontal bed. Here up thrown bed appear to the advance in the direction of dip, means up thrown bed will appear first or first formed bed. Then effect of inclined bed in strike fault, this is deep fault, and what is the effect of inclined bed in a strike fault. Strike fault means faulting occurs in a strike direction. So in strike fault with down thrown side in the direction of down thrown side go towards the direction of deep, this is your down throw side, and this is displaced towards the direction of deep, this is the direction of deep. And here what happens, omission of certain younger beds in down thrown side. See, here only two beds are seen, but actually there are three beds are present, so one bed is omitted. So in strike fault, omission of beds occur. Or with down throw side against the direction of dip, or see repetition of outcrop. Here omission of outcrop occurs, here repetition of outcrop, means opposite. Here see some beds are repeated. Okay, then here is the example of omission of bed. here 1 to 11 beds are present, but 1 to 4 beds are absent due to faulting. Next, effect of on folded beds. Default on anticline. If anticline is a fold, if in a folded bed fault occurs, what is the effect? The outcrop of beds of the upthrow side become widened. See, upthrow side of this is upthrow side, this is downthrow side, and this is in this upthrow side folds are widened, means spread. Then effect of default in syncline. Effect of syncline. So, outcrops of beds of the downthrow side become widened. In anticline, upthrow side fold are widened, but in syncline, downthrow side folds are widened. Next, this is all about effects of fault, and reverse faults produce opposite effect. The effect of reverse or thrust fault is frequently older strata upon younger strata. Then comes to the significance of fault. What is the significance of fault? So there are various significance of faults. Faults form a major defect in rocks and therefore a potential hazard in engineering and mining works. Fault may harmful towards the engineering and mining works. The fault plane itself is a very important fracture plane in the fault zone and therefore may act as the severe sources of leakage of water. Such weathering further reduces the competence of the rocks. Faults influence the movement of surface water also. In some cases where the deep direction of the fault plane and the surface slope occur in the same direction, landslide may occur. So it is the harmful effects on civil engineering and mining works. Then second is your fault gouge or pulverized rocks or and fault breccia form poor foundation material. This is your fault gouge or fault breccia. Fault breccia or fault gouge may cause poor foundation for the construction of buildings or rocks. Then faults add to difficulty and extra expenditure in excavation as broken rocks are difficult and costly to handle. In exploration or excavation process, faults are very expensive or faults are dangerous or very costly to handle. Fault movements trigger earthquakes and landslides. This is your fault plane, and in this fault location, earthquakes and landslides are occur. Then, knowledge of location and earthquake potential of faults is essential for seismic design of structure in earthquake region and forms an essential input to land use planning and sites of sitting of critical and vital installations like nuclear power stations, dams, reservoir, hydropower station, underground power station and other strategic installation pressure, tunnels, tube railways, hospitals, schools, important public buildings and community halls, submarine cables and mining activity. Suppose a fault runs through your estate and property and an earthquake occurs, you will gain land if it is a normal fault. We will lose land if it is a reverse fault. So it is also harmful for dam and tunnel. Effects of the large ground motion, impact type damage, strong contact impact of every adjacent wear body during the earthquake, fault rupture type and most complicated type for the dam. Fault also a harmful effect on tunnels. Fault at tunnel site, as in other civil engineering project, in tunnel too, faults are harmful and undesirable because they create a variety of problems. The active faults are places where there is scope for further recurrence of faulting, which will be accompanied by the physical displacement of litho units. Hence, such faults lead to dislocation and discontinuity in the tunnel alignment. Therefore, irrespective of the relation of the attitude of the fault with the tunnel courses, the occurrence of any active fault in tunnel is very undesirable. Next, fault zones are most undesirable features in dam and reservoir sites, constitute zones of potential hazard in tunnel routes. Filling of large reservoir behind dam across river valleys may include movement along fault plain of the region, causing disastrous earthquake. Then fault provides passage for percolation of water and mineralizing solutions. This is the good effect of fault. Fault is cause for storage of minerals and percolation of water. Fault zone forms sites of mineralization or silicification. This is the site of mineralization or coal seam. And fault throw and heave form the important factor, the exploration and recovery of mineral veins and coal seams in mining operations. Faults are responsible for lakes, swamp and marshy places. Fault traces often provide potential spring heads, and fault zones often form potential oil traps. Faults also discover the oil traps. So in some cases faults are very dangerous, and also in some cases faults are helpful for storage of minerals and oils and gas. So this is all about the fault significance and effect on fault on bedding. Thank you.